Hello guys, in the last few days I did several tests with the Magpie and FSR upscaling, and in this video I want to share some tips based on what I found. Well, the first one, and I think this is the most interesting for those who don't understand Chinese at all, there are already people making translated versions of Magpie into English. This makes it so much easier to use and configure the application. So let's take a proper look. Well, in the first section, we define the key combination to enable and disable the upscaling. But if we want, there's also this option that applies the upscaling to the focused window after 5 seconds. And the second setting is the upsampling method. Here I usually select the FSR, as my main interest is in upscaling games. And this is the method that works best for that. The third setting is the window capture method. The most recommended is WinRT capture. If you have problems with it, you still have the GDI option, but by my test, it is significantly slower. The fourth setting is used to solve the double cursor issues which appear in some games. I usually leave it at none, which does nothing, but if you have problems, try the second or third option. And the last option I'm going to talk about here is to show the frame rate. In the Chinese version, it was just selecting the checkbox in the corner of the screen. In the English version, it is hidden away in the option menu. And then in the section advanced, there you have the checkbox to show the FPS. The other advanced settings aren't very interesting. Some aren't even properly implemented yet, so I will not talk about them. Something that is still missing here is how to adjust the sharpness level, which is not available neither in the Chinese and English GUI. In my first video, we could see that some parts were over-sharpened. For example, the foliage had a strange appearance, looking more like paintings. Well, the first tip is, if you have an AMD video card, disable Radeon image sharpening in the Adrenaline software, in the general and per game setting. Otherwise, it can apply the sharpening filter twice, as the FSR already has built-in sharpening, so it is better to disable it in Adrenaline. But I also learned that there is in fact an option to adjust the sharpness level in the Magpie FSR. It just isn't available on the GUI. For that, we need to edit the scale models JSON file. With the file open on a text editor, we go to the FSR part and add a new line. Don't forget the comma. Here we will write sharpness inside quotes, a colon, a space and a numeric value, which needs to be between 0 and 1. The standard value seems to be around 0.5, but I'm not sure. After setting a new value, we just need to save the file and reopen Magpie. Here I applied the FSR upscaling with different values to make it easier to compare. If you think the sharpness level is too high, try a value closer to 0. Or if you want more sharpness, try values closer to 1. Other point I wanted to bring here is performance. I did some more control tests with The Witcher 3 using the game starting scene as a benchmark. I noticed that for the lower settings mostly, the Magpie framerate was most of the time below the MSI afterburner framerate. When playing the game on other areas, this effect isn't as pronounced. And this is also the case for other games. I did the same test with Assassin's Creed Origins and Odyssey, and the Magpie framerate was almost all the time above the value from Afterburner. I'm not sure why this happens, it could be for several reasons, but I suspect it's a lack of resources available for Magpie. That is, the game is leaving not enough processing power for Magpie to do the upscaling. To test this, I limited The Witcher's framerate to 40 FPS. As this was more or less the average it was running. This is done with the limit FPS value in the game's config file. After that I run the test again and the benchmark was much more stable, rarely going to values below the framerate indicated by MSI Afterburner. This means that if you want a more consistent experience, it may be recommended to limit the framerate to some reasonable value. This may not be ideal if one wants the highest FPS on a given game. Another concern some people may have is latency. That is, if there's any delay between a keyboard input and a screen movement. From what I have seen, if there is any, it is almost imperceptible. I'd say the delay should be in the order of the time of a frame. That is, if the game is running at 60 FPS, it is around or lower than 17 milliseconds, or 33 milliseconds for 30 FPS. This is because while the program captures a frame, upscales and displays the result, a new frame is already being generated by the game. If Magpie's frame rate is equal or greater than the frame rate at which the game is rendered, it means that it can do the entire process during the interval between frames. Well, I guess that was it. If you guys have another tips to share or any questions, write down in the comments. Thanks for watching, and until the next time.